How is everyone doing? And welcome to the Stat Room. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Von the Stat Man. You can follow me on Twitter at Von the Stat Man. And guys, check out my website, VonTheStatMan.com. Now, you might want to go on my website a few times a week because I might be giving out a few hidden gems that can help you to win your DFS contest each week and also help you dominate your fantasy leagues. So y'all ready? You ready to win your fantasy? All right, guys, so if you see on the screen, you can see the results from my last NBA Five Studs, and everyone did well except Marcus Smart, so I must do better today. So, guys, let's get right into the six-game slate. Welcome back, everyone, and let's break down this eight-game slate. All right, guys, so on eight-game slate, guys, you want to start off by creating your own head-to-head contest. Then you want to create your own 10-man contest. But on today's slate, guys, we had a stat, remember, guys, that took down first place. So in an unlimited entry GPP, yes, he won $50,000. So it is possible, ladies and gentlemen. So if you dare to risk it all, because remember, guys, without risk, there's no reward. So what are we doing this for, guys? So I recommend playing unlimited entry GPPs. Now, if you're doing it for a second income and you have a $500 bank account and you don't really want to, you know, gamble, then just play the two contests I've mentioned, the head-to-head contest that you create and the 10-man contest that you create. All right, guys, so I'm gonna break down the point guard position because I believe today's slate, the point guard position will be key in taking down any type of tournament. All right, so we got Doncic is ruled out. It is a shame what's happening to Damian Lillard. He's, I would say, next to Stephen Curry, he's probably the second best point guard in the NBA. And he just loves and he's loyal to Portland, which is not a bad thing. He doesn't want to leave. He believes that he can compete there. So I'm hoping that one of the star players will decide to go to Portland and join this young man because he's giving his all, but it looks like they're going to shut him down for the rest of the year. Halliburton's a game-time decision. Harden's also a game-time decision. He hasn't played in the past couple games. Kyrie Irving is a must-start. Since they've traded for Kyrie Irving, Dallas, they have a losing record. They're 7-13 since they picked up Kyrie Irving. It's not Kyrie Irving's fault, ladies and gentlemen. It's Luka Doncic's fault. If you watch the games, Luka Doncic is one of the worst defensive players in the league. Yeah, he can score and rebound. But if you score 30 and let the person that you're guarding score 30, it doesn't make sense. If you look at Kyrie, he's blocking shots, getting steals. So it's definitely like Kyrie. And you're going to see tonight because Kyrie will lead Dallas to a victory. Next. Fox, I don't anticipate Fox playing. There's no need to play him. I don't anticipate Brunson playing. McCollum is going to want to go into Portland and show them that it was a reason why him and Lillard were just such a fierce combination. So expect McCollum to have a big day. Don't like Westbrook against Chicago. Porter against New York on the second night of a back-to-back. He's going to probably go against Quickly. Won't be much defense played, so I won't play him on the second night of a back-to-back. I won't play Murray because you can get a lower option, even though I believe Murray will get you 35 points. Chris Paul against Utah, I see him getting about 40 points. The player's in the 7,000 range at the point guard position. I would take Chris Paul. Maxey, if he starts in the altitude, I will say that will be a pass for me. Jalen Green in New York. Guys, shooting guards just have phenomenal days in the Garden. I lived in New York, guys, and the Garden is a magical place. I've been to a few games, and it's just something about the Garden. I was there when the San Antonio Spurs won the championship when they beat the Knicks. I was there for the last game. I was in the arena. Guys, Madison Square Garden is electric. Holiday, I don't think he plays in the fourth quarter because Detroit is going to get railroaded big time. Clarkson and Simons is out. Hayes, don't like Hayes, even though point guards do well against Holiday. Conley's on the second night of a back-to-back. He probably will rest, I would assume. Melton, if he starts, I love Melton. Hyland is not going to get many minutes, so won't play him. I love Quickly. I believe he starts. And if Quickly starts, this could be one of them 50-point performances by Quickly because Houston has given up record numbers to point guards, shooting guards, and power forwards. Next, McConnell is only in play if he starts over Halliburton. So we got to wait to see if Halliburton plays. But if Halliburton is out, McConnell is also someone you can consider. Nembhard, I do like Nembhard. He's a pretty decent play. I don't like Kobe White against the Clippers. I do like Dunn against Phoenix. Man, he's so hot and cold, guys. If you play GPPs, you do want to take a gamble, but you want to take a safe gamble. And with Kawhi Leonard taking all of the shots, and then you're going to have Marcus Morris shooting, and have Russell Westbrook's going to shoot. So I don't know if there's enough shots for man, but he's a good player. He's just very inconsistent. But he's young, guys. And when you were young, were you consistent? So you got to be patient with this young man. But I believe he will become a great player at some point. Corey Joseph is out. Corey Payne. I don't know if you want to go with Cameron Payne. My apologies. Only way you want to consider him if you think that Phoenix could blow this game out. But in Utah, Utah's a scrappy team. But I just think Phoenix has too much firepower. If Markkanen don't play, this game could get out of hand. But if Markkanen plays, I still say Utah keeps it close because they just scrappy. Mitchell, let's see what he's been doing, guys. This guy gets, when he gets the minutes, he still doesn't perform. He had 32 in his last game, so expect 15 in this game. Burks is out. Noel, I don't like. Dusome, up and down with him. I do like Carter in this game because if it does blow out, then Carter would play the whole fourth quarter. And he didn't have a point in the last game, so I see Carter bouncing back. Beverly just played. He's going to be on the second night of a back-to-back, but the advantage for him is that he's in L.A. He played the Lakers, and tonight he's going to play the Clippers, so he did not have to travel. He's going to be motivated for this game, guys. I kind of like Beverly, but the Clippers are just a better team, so I won't play him. Don't like Hampton. Milton, hot and cold with him. And that's it, guys. So if you want to win your fantasy, start these players. You made it this far, hit that like button, share this video, and subscribe to my channel. You want to win your fantasy? You better start point guard Irving. You want to know why? Well, the Mavericks haven't looked so good since they brought him over, but he's going to be on 55-point watch and lead them to a victory. So if you want to win your fantasy, start Irving. You want to win your fantasy? You better start shooting guard McCollum. You want to know why? Well, he's going to return back to Portland, where he was the co-star with Lillard, and he's going to ball out. So if you want to win your fantasy, start McCollum. You want to win your fantasy? You better start small forward Herter. You want to know why? Well, he's on 40 points watch. So if you want to win your fantasy, start Herter. You want to win your fantasy? You better start power forward Anderson, aka Slow Mo. You don't know why? Well, he's going to give you 35 points. So if you want to win your fantasy, start Slow Mo. You want to win your fantasy? You better start center Lopez. You want to know why? Well, he has a 36-point floor today. So if you want to win your fantasy, start Lopez. And my word for today is energy. Ladies and gentlemen, I protect my energy at all costs, so I stay away from bad energy. Example, if someone calls your phone and you have to lay down to take a nap before you answer that phone, that person has bad energy. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not your place to entertain everybody's BS. You get a certain amount of energy so you can handle your task. Don't entertain bad energy, ladies and gentlemen. So when you have these people, and don't get me wrong, everyone has a right to be who they are, and you have a right to get the hell out of their face. So ladies and gentlemen, stay away from bad energy. Love you guys.